I hope you're all doing fine and you're all doing well and that you're all staying inside your homes very safe and sound in this time of the coronavirus crisis. As you already know, we're going to be talking about the coronavirus crisis today. But before I begin, let me quickly wait to see if the test, if this session is live or not. So we'll just wait for a second to find out if the session is live. Once we are live, then we can continue. For right now, let me quickly brief you about the All India Scholarship Test and Mentorship Program that An Academy is hosting from the 26th to the 30th of this month. So on the 26th of this month, we are having a scholarship test for all CAT aspirants in India. So if you or any of your friends are planning to write CAT, if you've been thinking about this thing, then you are in absolutely the right place. You're absolutely doing the right thing, you know. So fear not, your preparation will be taken care of by An Academy, by us. So the plan is very simple. On the 26th of April, from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m., we are going to be having a test for which you can log on to the An Academy app and register. Once you've registered for this test on the 26th, log in at 9 p.m. from 9 to 10, write your scholarship test. There will be 30 questions, 10 from each of the sections of CAT. So 10 from VRC, that's my section, 10 from LRDI, and another 10 from quantitative aptitude. Now, once you've written this test, what will happen is you will get your national rankings. Remember, An Academy has a very big student base, and so there will be lots and lots of people who will be competing in this test. So you will get your ranking, and let's say you get your rank within top 500. So then, my friends, you have a lot to look forward to. From the minimum scholarship of a 1 month subscription to the maximum of a scholarship of an entire year subscription, you can look forward to, you know, doing some amazing learning with us. Once you're through with this, on the 27th, 28th and 29th, we'll be having 3 mentorship sessions with 3 of the faculty's educators from An Academy. And they will tell you a lot more about, you know, how you should be preparing. So Arun Sharma sir, Manoj Mahajan sir and Praveen Tyagi sir will be live there. And they will help you out. So friends, if you're really interested in joining up for CAT, do write this test. I think this will give you a very good idea of where you stand right now vis-a-vis where you need to go, as well as, you know, helping you join An Academy for, you know, for an amazing, amazing scholarship, with an amazing, amazing scholarship. So that's what I'd like to say today. Of course, remember my upcoming courses. On the 1st of May is my complete course on reasoning-based questions, which is from 1st of May to the 6th of May, 4 days of classes, 2 hours each. And then, of course, my capsule course on vocabulary and paragraph-based reasoning for VARC starts on 7th of May at 7 p.m. again, and this will be again 4 days for 2 hours. The ongoing courses, as you already know, you've been attending this, and remember, I'm still doing the lockdown quizzes, and there are still 5 more editions of the lockdown quizzes to go. So fear not, wait not, waste not. Just come and, you know, enjoy the lockdown quizzes. And of course, if you're looking at doing a lot of learning, then these are the courses for you. Remember, my referral code is ABHICAT. ABHI for Abhilasha, that's me, and CAT, of course, is your aim. So ABHICAT is the referral code. You can use this to log on and get a 10% discount on all our CAT 2020 and CAT 21 courses. Friends, today, of course, I don't need to really introduce myself to you, so let me not do that. You can just take a look at my bio and, of course, my pretty picture, as I always say. And hey, yeah. So today we are going to be talking of the coronavirus crisis in India versus the other. So let's find out what is the status of the coronavirus crisis in India vis-a-vis the other countries. Remember, friends, earlier this year, Wuhan became the the genesis of the coronavirus crisis, from where it all originated, and it has this coronavirus has spread throughout the world. And today, as of today, there are some nearly 25 lakh people across the world who've been infected by the coronavirus. It has been declared to be a pandemic, and all countries, or almost all countries, are fighting a big fight to make sure that they don't lose as many people to coronavirus as Italy has lost or as the US has lost. So today, with this thought in mind, that let us try and analyze what India is doing for this coronavirus crisis and how we are handling our coronavirus crisis. That's what we will do today. So let's just get started. Let's understand a few of the statistics and we take it from here. So the coronavirus update, what is the current situation? So presently there are, like I said, 25,67,327 confirmed cases of coronavirus. Remember, these are only the people who've been tested. So there will be many more who have not yet been tested, and therefore we don't really know the status of these people. So far, 1,77,521 deaths have occurred due to the coronavirus, while 5,98,593 people have already recovered from the coronavirus. Since it has been recorded late last year in China, remember that this crisis has spread across the world and it has actually affected the entire world. But because different countries are testing us at different rates, and therefore it is very difficult to say that what is the exact situation in a lot of countries, because they might just not be testing enough people to find the exact quantum or the exact situation with the disease. So anyway, let's take a look at the worldwide infection growth. If you look at this chart, which we've picked up from Johns Hopkins, it shows you the number of cases since the day of the 100th case. So we start with the day when we had 100 cases in that country, in a particular country, and vis-a-vis today, or here at the 60th day. So if you look at Australia has been able to kind of steady the decline, while Japan is still on an increasing trend. China has managed to kind of plateau the crisis, so they have been able to stop the coronavirus crisis growth as of now. Remember, Wuhan just opened up after some 75 days of closure, and China is reporting no new cases of coronavirus. Italy, Germany, France, Spain, UK, all of these countries are among the fastest growth of coronavirus countries. They are all showing this extremely fast growth of the coronavirus crisis. At the top of this chart, unfortunately, is the world leader, United States of America, with nearly 10 lakh cases, or almost 10 lakh cases that have been reported. It's not yet reached 10 lakh, but it is about to reach 10 lakh. So the crisis grows across the world, friends, and it is getting more and more desperate for all humans anywhere in the world. Let's take a look at different countries and let's see where India would stand. So of course, as we've already said, this is what we are saying. This now is the confirmed deaths for COVID-19. So the number of people who have died in each one of these countries, let's also understand that. So the maximum number of deaths have occurred in the US, some 8 lakh plus, almost 9 lakh people have died in the US. Nearly 1 lakh people have, I was going to say 1 lakh and I just said 9 lakhs. So nearly a lakh of people, not exactly a lakh, but almost a lakh is the figure that the US is facing currently. France, Italy, UK, Spain are almost at the same situation. Each one of them is facing nearly 20 to 25 to 30,000 deaths. Germany, of course, is a little lower with around 7 to 8,000 deaths. China, which has managed to stem the decline, but the number of deaths is still increasing and has now reached a small plateau. We don't know. We will try and find out more as the crisis continues. Japan is still at a very low, so they have around 500 deaths as of now. Australia, still lesser, they have nearly 100 deaths. So, of course, in this picture, US, of course, again is, number one with the number of deaths that have occurred there. Now, India, of course, doesn't compare in this parameter at all. Let us also look at India and see where India stands in this data. Now the situation in our neighborhood, the situation in Indian neighborhood, let's try and understand that. Now in our neighborhood, what is happening? Let's look at this chart which we've picked up again from John Hopkins CSE. Let's take this. So India currently has 20,178 confirmed cases of COVID-19. Thailand has 2,826 confirmed cases. Vietnam has 268. Malaysia has 5,482. Singapore has surprisingly 10,141 cases. Indonesia 7,135. Philippines some 6,599. Hong Kong at 1,000 people. Japan with around 11,500 people. South Korea with around 10,000, 10,500 people. And the worst hit district, let us say, across Asia is Hubei, or the Hubei region of Asia, where there are some 68,128 confirmed cases. So if you compare this data with India, and remember India's population is just next to China's population, then remember we are the second most populated country across the world. So it's China and then us. So with China just having, China having 68,128 deaths in one region, and look at India, all of India having only 20,000 deaths, the confirmed cases, the figures are very, very good for India. So even though testing remains slow, the situation seems apparently to be under control. It's not as bad as we think it is. Coronavirus cases, of course, like I told you, is 20,178 as of today. Number of deaths are 645, and those who have recovered is 3,976. So from all indicators, it appears that India is doing much better than any of the other cases. Friends, can you all see me? Because I'm not able to see myself in, on my phone. So is it that you can see me, or if you cannot see me, please do indicate. All right. So I think it is occurring, and so that is the current state of affairs as far as India is concerned, as compared to Asia. So we have just 645 deaths, which is excellent. If you go back to this previous chart, 645 deaths would put us at par with Japan, where the population is not even one-tenth of India, and that's how it is. Let's look at the next, let us look at the situation in India's neighborhood. So let's talk of the confirmed cases. We've already spoken of this. Let's understand. In Asia, the cases are still growing, but the spread and mortality rates have slowed down. So we have kind of slowed down the mortality rate. In India, our nationwide lockdown has managed to push the doubling rate to 6.2 days. Now remember, every certain number of days, the number of deaths in coronavirus has been doubling. So while Italy, it doubled in just 3 days. Okay, from the 7th of March to the 11th of March, in fact, the number of coronavirus cases went from 3K to 30K in Italy. So it not even doubled, it went like 10 times. So India, with the lockdown, the strict lockdown that we have instituted, we've been able to manage to push down, to slow down the doubling rate to 6.2, which is better than most of the countries as of now. The situation in Europe, let's look at Europe also, and let's understand a little bit about Europe. Italy, of course, like I said, was one of the worst hit countries in Europe, with nearly 1,83,957 cases. Spain again has some 2 lakh cases. France has some 1.5 lakh cases. Germany again 1.5 lakh cases. Belgium, a tiny country that it is, has some 40,000 cases, 41,000. UK has some 1,29,000 cases. And remember, the Crown Prince Charles is also afflicted with coronavirus. Ireland has 16,000 deaths. Iceland, tiny country that it is, has 700 deaths. Norway, 7,000. Sweden some 15,000, Finland some 4,000, Romania 9,000, Greece 2,400. If you look at Africa, then Morocco at 3,200, Algeria at 2,800, Egypt at 3,400, 3,500 approximately. Israel, very small country that it is, has some 14,000.